Okay, everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is a service case. This is a service meat case. This is called actually the cremería, and this is carnes frías. This side of the cooler was not holding good temperature. So these are two units. It's right there. This is 24 feet long, circuit A9. Now that I wrote that on there, I had to figure that out. So 24 feet, this is 12 foot, another 12 foot, three sections each. Each section, 4 feet. We got our expansion valve. This is for the left side. See? Earlier it had frost on it. So does this one, right there. Yep, right there. Over here, this one is actually the coldest of these three on the left unit. And I didn't see any ice on this one, so, well, I guess, yeah, there's a little bit. Okay, but this one's the coldest. So, what the fuck is going on? So I wanted y'all to see all of that here. There's actually some ice on this one, which is surprising because earlier, I didn't really see it, but I was gandering from way over there. See the ice? What the hell's wrong with my damn camera? There, I think that's better. Now y'all can see more like what it really looks like. Okay. Wow, when I switch from wide to ultra wide, the freaking camera picture quality goes out the window. So I'm not gonna do ultra wide anymore. Yeah, that's a much better picture. Okay, so before I pump this circuit down, I'm gonna go up to the rack and I'm gonna bring this down to like 30 by adjusting the EPR. This should go really quick, and I should see this one respond to that also. Got me a new toy today, so that's cool. Pretty damn cold in here, I guess. All right, so I adjusted that EPR. You can see this is responding. Pretty freaking cold. 31 over here. Now this is another circuit, completely different circuit. This one doesn't seem to be working as good as that one over there. That's a big difference, 35 and 31. We might have expansion valve adjustments dialing in that need to be done. So here on Sporlin, manual number 10-9, you can find this online. It's a bulletin 1019. You see? Okay. So Sporlin says Portland says, right here, suggested superheat setting 6 to 8 for an evaporator temperature right there, 6 to 8. So we're way too high on all of them. And I know for a fact that that one doesn't do shit. So let's see if this one does anything. And they stick this one all up in there. Look at that. Alright, so I got some response from this thing over here. I dunked in this hot water. Sorry I didn't get it on camera, but it responded. Now, this bulb was on this pipe that's doing a U-bend right there. So, explain to you what's going on here. These are two coils piped in series with each other. We've got the first coil goes down here, up, and across through there. Here, I show you. And this one. See? We've got that coil, and then it comes out of that coil and down up through this little channel here, and it feeds this coil up here, which is a gravity coil, I guess. Okay? Now, this one, I'm not going to have to change that valve. That valve, I think, is going to be good, and I think now that I put this bulb on this line over here, I think it's going to do a lot better. And look at this, we've got ice up here on this thing too now. We didn't have that before. So we're going to let that run and stabilize. Need to figure out. Let's see, that sensing bulb is there. So let's see if this one reacts as well. All right, I'm going to get it on camera for you guys this time. Now, if it responds, well, we should hear it, you know? So let's listen for this thing. Let's see, here goes. It's responding. I think I can hear it. So we're gonna watch for a change in temperature, both on the discharge and on my line. So we're at 39 over there. Ooh, look at that. That bitch is dropping. So that's cool, you see? So that's how the TXV sensing bulb shit works, you see? Alright, so we know that one's working. Okay, good. Now I'm gonna do this one over here, because earlier this thing wasn't reacting at all. Now, if it reacts right now, I'm gonna do this one over here. Because earlier, this one wasn't reacting for me at all. If it reacts now, I'm gonna fucking lose my mind. Better not. Yeah, it's not. That's what I thought. So this one I'm gonna have to change. And to do that, I gotta pump the whole system down. Okay, better get to it. that's that. About to go turn this son of a bitch back on. And we're gonna see what happens. Okay. Pressure test. I think we're good. All right, I'm gonna go open up this circuit.
Yep.
Let's see what temperature we got up to.
Ooh, we 55, 53, whatever.
That's pretty damn hot. All right, time to turn it on. Make sure to mount the sensing bulb. Well, I think it's doing pretty good. All right, so y'all know how I know this thing is freaking working? Because this right here, it's cold and icy. I'm gonna have to adjust that EPR again here in a second. Oh yeah, that's way too cold. Alright, that's gonna do it for me for tonight. I've had it. It is like 3 in the morning. And Well, my case is doing a hell of a lot better than it was. All of this is cold, this is sweating, this is working, so I'm calling it done. See y'all on the next one. Catch y'all later.